Hi, my name's Rosie and I'm a medical student and I'm here with Stuart, the medical dean, and we're here to answer your questions. All right, Stuart, I have the first question. So what are some of the coolest jobs that UQ Medicine's alumni are now doing?
Not sure, Rosie. I fully accept the premise of the question because I think all jobs in medicine are pretty cool. As a psychiatrist, of course, I'm somewhat biased that those of our graduates who are practicing in psychiatry, looking after people with mental health issues, that's pretty cool. But some of the other jobs that I really admire are the work of our rural generalists, caring for people in regional, rural and remote Australia. Other jobs that that some of my friends think are pretty cool are supporting Formula One teams or AFL teams, but there's a lot of cool stuff to do in medicine. Rosie, what's been the most unexpected thing you've been happy to discover at UQ?
I think coming to UQ Medicine, I was really excited and surprised to see the diversity of students, which makes us really unique and I think adds a lot to the experience here, knowing that both academically and clinically, you can travel overseas, but just having friends and colleagues and contacts all over the world is something that, as someone that wants to travel and work overseas, is just the best unexpected surprise. At what stage in the MD program do your students get clinical or hands-on experience?
So we seek to provide sort of early meaningful clinical experience for our students from the first year. In the first year, as you might expect, it is in a simulated clinical skills type environment. But then from year two, our students are on the wards in the hospitals learning the practice of medicine. By years three and four, it's a fully immersive clinical experience. Rosie, what does a day in the life of a medical student look like?
Ooh, well, I think the wonderful part of a medical degree is that no 2 days are the same. I think it changes over your degree, even when you're in the early parts of your degree and you spend a lot of time on campus. You could be in one day in the anatomy lab with cadavers, you could be in a physiology practical doing experiments on your peers, and you could be in a lecture, you can be practicing your clinical skills. And in the second part of your degree, when you're in the hospitals full time, it's hands-on, it's clinical experience, standing by the bedside all day in surgery, and again, every single day is different. How do you prepare students for the future when we don't know what the future will look like?
That's a great question, Rosie, and I think that's one of the benefits of being in a comprehensive university like UQ. Whilst yes, we have an eye on preparing you for day one as a clinician, you're quite right, we don't know what's going to happen beyond that. And that's really about a thorough foundation in the biomedical sciences, in the social sciences, and in public health to prepare you for challenges which we don't yet anticipate. Rosie, how does the way you learn at UQ prepare you with the skills you need to face an unknown future?
I think the way you learn at UQ, the fact that it's every different kind of learning sort of covers all of the different potential futures that we might be going into. So in the medical program, there's the sort of core learning around the history of medicine, around knowing what is currently known. But then we also learn about research. We learn about technology on the wards, and we're trying to predict what could potentially be the future that we're working in to prepare us for the workforce of the future. So what makes a successful medical student? And are they the same things that make a successful doctor?
I think there are three things that make a successful medical student, and I think they're pretty much the same things that make for success as a doctor throughout the rest of your career. I think the first thing is around relationships, the importance of that secure base. Friends and family, people who can keep you grounded. I think one of the other things that makes for a successful medical student and a successful doctor is curiosity. Constantly challenging, asking the awkward questions, don't accept the status quo. People who are really prepared to push back the boundaries of knowledge. Just because my generation did it doesn't necessarily mean it's the right thing to do. And I think the third thing, and I think this is something we all struggle with, and that's dealing with uncertainty. That medicine is about reckoning with risk, that there are very few yes-no answers in medicine. It's about balancing probabilities. And I think dealing with that can be very challenging and confronting as a medical student, and it's something we continue to struggle with throughout our professional lives. Rosie, what's the most interesting thing you've learned that has not been part of your coursework?
I think When I first sort of started becoming interested in medicine, I had this one idea of what a doctor would be and what a medical degree can sort of lead you. It's to a clinician, the GP that you loved when you were growing up, whatever it might be. But I think sort of adjacent to the program, I've been so lucky to see the vast diversity in careers that a medical degree can give you, what sort of the medical field is and how far that scope goes. So looking at whether or not I want to be doing public health and policy, or if I want to be looking at technology, and the future of technology and health, there's so many different things that I was passionate about and sort of skills that I had growing up that I didn't necessarily think I would be able to investigate and celebrate in a medical career. But I've been so excited to find out that just being a doctor, or the excitement of being a doctor, is only sort of one part of it. Stuart, if you could give me one piece of advice that would set me apart as a job candidate, what would it be?
I think the advice I'd give you, sort of Rosie, is to be yourself, is to be authentic. I think the people who sort of come across really well at interview are the individuals who sort of let their true self shine through. And of course, if you're pretending to be somebody else at an interview and they hire you because they think you're somebody different to who you are, it's going to be a pretty difficult job. You're having to act all of the time. So I think the key piece of advice is always be true to yourself and be authentic. So Rosie, this is the last question. What have you learned about yourself since you started your studies at UQ?
Something I've learned about myself is how important it is to really believe in yourself if you're trying something new, to really sort of foster and hold on to self-confidence, to try different things and to stretch yourself, because you never know. You never know what could happen. You never know where you might go or where you might succeed if you never try.